Good morning, everybody. Welcome to you in the world of economics. It's me, Atul Kumar Srivastava, your economics lecturer. Now today, I will teach you unit 2 of 11th class economics, demand, supply, and equilibrium. So the topic today which I will teach you, that is called movement along demand curve. This topic I will teach you today. So we know better, demand is such a function which is increased or decreased due to various of factors. So the demand increases or the demand decreases, then for increasing or decreasing of demand, there are different types of determinants. For example, here the first determinant for increasing or decreasing the demand, that is price. The second determinant, that is called income of the consumer. The third determinant, that is called taste and habits. The fourth is fashion. The fifth is population, the sixth is advertisement, and the seventh is prestige. And like so, there are so many determinants, there are so many factors which cause to increase or decrease the demand. We know better, when the price of any goods that will increase, then certainly the demand will decrease. And when the price of any goods that will decrease, then certainly the demand will increase. Like so, the income, when the income of a consumer that will increase, then automatically the demand will also increase. And when the income of a consumer that will decrease, then automatically demand will decrease. But here, this topic which we are studying, the movement along demand curve, then the movement along demand curve not explain about the another determinants. Here the movement of demand curve just explain about the price. Listen, what will happen if the price of any goods that will increase or if the price of any goods that will decrease? So movement along demand curve, it is related to the price. So the movement of demand curve say to us that when the price of any goods that will increase or that will decrease, then what will happen to the demand curve? Then we know better, when price of any goods that will decrease, then demand will increase and the demand curve will shift from left side upward to right side downward. Like so, when the price of any goods that will increase, then demand will decrease and demand curve will move from right side upward to left side, right side downward to left side upward. So explaining about the movement of this DD curve, demand curve, it is especially called the movement along demand curve. So one thing I would like to inform you here, that actually the movement, what is called movement, here we have to get the meaning. Movement means not the shifting this place to another place, just moving in one curve, this is called the movement. Because if this DD curve, it will shift in another curve, then that is called shift. But the movement, when the demand curve just, it will move upward or downward, it is called movement. Then why does this DD curve, I mean the demand curve, it will move either downward or upward? Then here is the first reason, or the main reason, that is called price. Because the movement along demand curve, it is happen especially due to change in price. So here I will explain this movement along demand curve by drawing here a curve. Listen, here is a curve. In this curve, on OX axis, this OX axis represents about the demand. Like so, OY axis represents, this OY axis represents about the price. This DD, this is the demand curve. So, if we will take a midpoint, the mid price, this is P1. When the price of any goods, that is P1, at this situation, how much is the demand? The demand is just Q1. And where is the demand curve? The demand curve is here at A point. But due to any reason, the price of the goods, it has been increased, it has become P2. Then we know better, when price will increase, then automatically demand will decrease, because due to increase in price, the price is very expensive, then demand will decrease. So the price, it has been changed from P1 to P2, so that the demand, it has been decreased from Q1 to Q, and the demand curve, it has moved from A point to C point, from right side downward to left side upward. So technically it is called contraction of demand curve. It is called contraction of demand curve. Actually, contraction of demand curve, it is happen due to increase in price and due to decrease in demand. But on the another hand, the price, when it was P1, demand was Q1, and this demand curve, it was here at A point. But due to any reason, the price of the goods, it has been decreased, it has become P. Then we know better, when price of any goods, it will decrease, then automatically demand will increase. So that due to decrease in price, when the price, it has become from P1 to P, then automatically the demand, it has been increased from Q1 to Q2. And this demand curve, it has been moved from A point to C point. So when the price, it was P1, demand was Q1, and demand curve was here at A point, but the price, it has been decreased, it has become P, then demand, it has been increased, it has become Q2, and this demand curve, it has moved from A point to D point, and technically it is called extension of demand curve. So demand curve either moving upward, that is called contraction of demand curve, or demand curve moving downward due to decrease in price and due to increase in demand, then it is called extension of demand curve, and the both process, that is called movement of demand curve. And here I would like to inform you that the movement of demand curve, it is not happen due to the income of the consumer, due to the taste and habits, due to the fashion, due to the change in population, due to the change in advertisement, or due to the change in prestige. So the movement along the demand curve, it is especially happen due to change in price. And when price will increase, then demand will decrease, and demand curve will move from right side downward to left side upward. It is called contraction of demand curve. Like so, when price will decrease, then demand will increase, and demand curve will shift from left side upward to right side downward. It is called extension of demand curve, and these both process, that is called movement of demand curve. And movement of demand curve, it is especially happen due to not change in another factor, it is happen due to change in price. So this is called movement of, this is called movement of demand curve. Thank you.